protesters attempted to basically disrupt a school board meeting this week in Chicago after the Proud Boys had actually encouraged angry parents to show up for this event to challenge a pornographic book that was allegedly being offered in the school library. Now, the book in question is genderqueer. It is not pornographic. It is not meant to arouse any kind of sexual passion among anyone. So it is definitely not pornographic. But the parents showed up saying, get this out of here. We don't want it in our library. And you know who stood up and defended the book? High school students themselves. Students from the district showed up at that meeting and ended up schooling those backwards, closed-minded parents on what is really happening in that high school. Let me read some of what happened here. This is from one senior. I'm not going to name their names. Inclusion matters to young people. This is why we must have this book in our school's library. It brings comfort to people who feel unsolved and cast out. Another one, a junior, said that it was ironic that the protesters were wearing American flag clothes and masks while calling for a book to be banned, saying the issue was about free speech. Another one, a former student, showed up and said, despite the noise in the community, this is just a small minority who want to ban the book. Genderqueer is an opportunity for a child who may be exploring or questioning their identity to take a look and look at more information. And here's the thing, the school board didn't even plan on bringing up that book at this meeting. The issue was forced upon them by these protesters, again, who showed up at the encouragement of the Proud Boys to cause disruption, to make this into an issue, and thank God these students showed up and put them in their place. Now, is that going to have an effect on the school board? That's going to remain to be seen. But, you know, we've heard from all of these Republicans, you know, oh, we've got to protect the children. We've got to listen to the children. They don't want this. Okay, well, these kids are saying this isn't a big deal. The book is not required reading. It's just available. The child would have to choose to go to the library to choose that book to read it. So suddenly you Republicans have been screaming about personal choice for the last 18 months. Now you're telling us you don't want these kids to have their personal choice? They don't get to choose which books they want? Oh man, the hypocrisy is just overwhelming at this point. And that again is what the junior was pointing out. You guys come here decked out in your American flag gear, looking like the ultimate patriots, and you want to silence free speech? You want to burn and ban books? That's not what this country should be about. That's not where this country should be in the year 2021. Republicans want to take this country backwards. They want to take us backwards on every possible issue. LGBTQ issues, women's rights, minorities. They want to take us back 100, maybe even 200 years. They want to ban books. They've suggested burning these books. They don't know the difference between pornography and a regular book. I'd say this country was in trouble, but the fact that the young people showed up, defended this so voraciously, I can't help but think that maybe we got a little hope. Maybe there is something worth looking forward to in this country. And if there is, it lies with those young people right there. Hey, thanks for watching, and if you want even more Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to like, comment, share, but most importantly, subscribe. And don't forget, you can find me on all social media outlets at Farron Balanced.